You're my help in the time of trouble. You're my healer and my way maker. You're my provider tonight, oh God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. We praise your wonderful name. We invite your presence into this building tonight. Hallelujah. Bless the song service tonight. Bless the ministry of your word. Let everything be done to your honor and glory. We give you praise and we give you thanks tonight, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, clap your hands unto him. Worship him. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Brother Tavares and Brother Andrew's going to come and lead us in song. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Yes. Praise God. We're here to worship. Yes. We're here to worship. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Come on, clap your hands.
Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. No other name I know. Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. No other name. Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. No other name I know.
Come on, clap your hands.
Of Jesus. Healing in the name of Jesus. There is healing in the name of Jesus. No other name I
There's
know.
There's power in the name.
There is power in the name of Jesus. Power in the name of Jesus. Power in the name of Jesus. No other name I know.
Healing.
Name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Of Jesus. No other name I know.
Oh, bless that wonderful name
of Jesus. Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. No other name I know.
Very soon we're going to see the King. Hallelujah. We love you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We exalt your name. We exalt your name. Thank you, Lord. We're excited to be in your house. We're delighted to be in your presence, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, we look forward to seeing you one day. Hallelujah. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King.
Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we're going to see the King. Soon and very soon, going to see the King. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King.
See the King.
Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we're going to see the King.
No more dying,
no more crying there. We are going to see the King.
Oh, there's no more crying there.
We are going to see the King. No more crying there.
We are going to see the King. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We're going to see the King. Going to see the King. It won't be long.
Soon and very soon.
We are going to see the King.
Oh, we worship
soon
you.
Soon and very soon.
Oh, God,
we
there's
are
a promise.
Going to see the
Hallelujah,
King.
Your promise to return.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. We're going to see the King.
Soon and very soon.
We are going to see the King. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we're going to see the King.
No more dying,
no more dying.
Hallelujah,
we are going to see the King.
No more dying.
We are going to see the King.
Listen to our hearts. Hallelujah.
We are going to see the King. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're going to see the King.
No more dying there.
We are going to see the King.
No more.
No more dying there. To see the King, no more dying there. We are going to see the King.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
We're going to see the King.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
We're going to see the King.
Hallelujah, praise your name, God. Praise your name, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise your name, Lord. We exalt your name. Thank you, Jesus. Go ahead and worship God. Oh, we want to touch you this evening, God. We're not just wasting our time. We are here to glorify the Most High God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus, lover of my soul. Jesus, I will never let you go. Taking me from the miry clay. Set my feet upon a rock, and now I know. I say I love you, I need you. You're my hallelujah, I never let you go. Jesus, lover of my soul.
Jesus, I will never let you go.
My Savior, my closest friend. You're my, oh, and I'll never let you go. I love you. I'll never let you go. Oh, my Savior,
my Savior,
oh, my closest friend. Hallelujah,
I will worship you.
Hallelujah,
there is a
my I love you.
I need you.
You're my one may fall. I'll never
until the very end. Jesus, Jesus, oh, lover of my soul. Jesus, I will never let you go. Taking me from the mountain. Until the very end.
Somebody sing Jesus.
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 Lover of my soul.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
I will never let you go.
Hallelujah. Oh, my Savior. Hallelujah, Lord.
I will worship you.
Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Jesus is your close friend. Worship him. I'll never let you go, Lord. I'll never let you go, Jesus. You're my closest friend. You call me friend. Oh yes, a relationship with you, God. Closeness with you, intimacy. That's where I want to be, Jesus, is to be with you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to your name, glory to your name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. There's a sweet spirit of God here. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Right now, we're going to take the needs to prayer. Amen. God, he calls you friend. And so as a friend, he'll respond to you, to your need. He loves you. He loves you so much, he gave his life to you. His love to you is not dependent on how much you are able to do this week. It's based on who you are. Amen. You are a child of God, and he loves you. Amen. He loves you. Don't ever doubt that he loves you. And because he loves you, he wants to answer your prayer tonight. So if you have a need, just lift up your hand in faith, knowing the love of God. That's beyond all knowledge. It's beyond all pain. If you know you have pain, it's beyond any financial need. If you know that God is beyond that knowledge, the love of God is beyond all and surpasses all that you know. So in faith, lift your hand up, present that need to God, and we're going to prayer right now, Lord Jesus. We're praying, Lord God, that you meet that need. Whatever financial situation, you're beyond that. You love us so much, Lord God. You'll answer that prayer. right now, Jesus, any pain, Lord God, we're asking you, knowing who we are, the children of God, the sons of God, born again, covered by your blood, in the name of Jesus, I'm praying to supply that need where there's a job and an employment, God, I'm asking you as a friend, Lord, supply that need in faith. I pray it in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Go ahead and clap your hands, believing that God has answered your prayer. Clap it, come on. Clap your hand in faith in Jesus' name. Glory to you, God. You are worthy. Glory to God of the Most High. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Worship with us as we go into it.
All I need is you, Lord. Use you, Lord. All I need is you. Somebody sing from their hearts.
All I need is you, Lord. Is you, Lord. All I need is you.
Together worthy, altogether wonderful.
lovely. You're altogether worthy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This church. Oh, here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down.
Here I am to before you, God.
I'm thankful, God, that you're my God. You're a just God. Holy God. Powerful God, hallelujah, full to me. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. It's worthy, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Lift your hands and give him praise tonight. I love you, Lord. I worship you tonight. Hallelujah. I bless your mighty name. I praise you tonight, Jesus. I'm here to worship you. I'm here to praise you. I'm here to bless you tonight, God. Hallelujah. 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 I worship you, Jesus. I bless you tonight, Father. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I love you, Jesus. I praise your wonderful name. Hallelujah. Isn't it wonderful to bask in the presence of God? Hallelujah, to feel his presence, to know that he is with us every step of the way. I don't know about you, but I get real comfort when I quote that scripture that says, he said he'd never leave me nor forsake me, but he'll go with me all the way to the end of the world. To God be the glory. Amen. Clap your hands unto him and give him praise. Thank you, Jesus. You are faithful, God. You are faithful. Praise God. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Sister Nicole, did you happen to bring a handkerchief tonight? Come on up. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Many of you know that Sister Nicole's father-in-law, Fayette's dad, has been in and out of the hospital, and while we were on vacation, I received a text from Brother Fayette and wanting us to pray for his dad. And of course, we stopped what we were doing and we began to pray. The good news is God answered the prayer and brought him out, brought him home. And then they had another close bout, what was it, last weekend? Amen. And back in the hospital. And I don't know the whole story, but Sister Nicole was telling me on Tuesday nights, amen, that now this is a miracle because her father-in-law is a Muslim, amen. But there was a man that walked through the ICU, I guess it was ICU, and said he wanted to pray for him. Hallelujah. Amen. I don't know about you, but I believe that God sent an angel that night. Hallelujah. And touched Fayed's dad. Tonight, he's out of the hospital and he's back home. Amen. Hallelujah. He still had some difficulties, but I felt in prayer on Tuesday night that we're going to do like the apostles did. We're going to anoint a handkerchief. We're going to send that handkerchief to Florida. Amen. And I believe when they lay that handkerchief on him in the name of Jesus, not only is he going to receive healing, but I believe his spiritual eyes are going to be open. I'm praying for a revelation of truth to come into his life, that he would also repent of his sins and be baptized in Jesus' name and filled with the gift of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. So if you'll bring that handkerchief up here, Sister Nicole, would you just reach your hand out tonight? Hallelujah. Father, we touch and we anoint this handkerchief tonight. You said if two of us touching any one thing would ask in your name that it shall be done. Just as the apostles of old touched and anointed handkerchiefs, we anoint this handkerchief tonight, God, that when it's placed upon Brother Fayed's dad, that the healing virtue of the Lord would flow through this cloth. You would dispatch ministering angels into that room, God, that you would heal him, strengthen him, lift him up in the power of your might, that you would open his eyes, that you would open his understanding, that you would show him that all power in heaven and earth is in the name of Jesus Christ, that he would receive truth, that you would use Fayed and Sister Nicole to be a witness and a lighthouse and a testimony to him, God, that he would repent of his sins, that he would be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of those sins, and that you would fill him with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost. Lord, it's not by our might and it's not by our power, but we're believing, touching this one thing, asking for divine intervention tonight. As Sister Nicole and Brother Fayed go and present this to him, God, I pray let your angels have charge round about them. Bind every hindrance to the moving of your spirit. Let your will be done. We give you praise and we give you thanks in advance in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Give God the praise tonight. Hallelujah. Not by our might, not by our power, but by the name that is above every other name. Hallelujah. I'm looking for a miracle. I'm looking for signs and wonders to happen. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, as a testimony of what God can do. There's nothing God can't do. Hallelujah. Let's just give him praise again. We thank you in advance, God. We thank you for the miracle in advance. Hallelujah. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise for touching Fayed's dad, for opening his understanding. We praise you for repentance and baptism and the infilling of the Holy Ghost, Lord, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I believe it's going to happen. Hallelujah. I'm going to look for a testimony. Praise God. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. That's what God can do. I said, that's what God can do. I feel a little faith in the house tonight. I just want to tell you, no matter what you're going through, whatever the trial is tonight, Jesus is your answer. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give him praise and give him thanks. Hallelujah. You are the healer, God. You are the way maker. You are the provider. We bless your mighty name. Amen. 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 Praise God. Well, I like what I feel tonight. Hallelujah. I said, you like what you feel tonight? You like to feel the power of God? Guess what? God can move on a Thursday night like he can move on a Sunday morning or any other time he gets ready to move. Praise God. Amen, amen. Praise God. We're going to ask Brother Daryl to come. We're going to receive our offering as you prepare to give. Amen. Thank you for your giving. Thank you for your faithfulness and your tithes and offerings. Amen. God is doing good things in our midst. Praise God. Remember, amen, All Nations Sunday coming up the 18th of this month, All Nations Sunday, the Thursday before All Nations Sunday, we will have, instead of our regular Thursday night service, we're going to have a talent night, amen. We did this last year, amen. So if you have a talent or would like to act like you have a talent, praise God. Amen. Praise God. Come on and see Sister Bleedy and Sister Knox, I think it is. Amen. And we're going to have a good time of fellowship in the Lord. Amen. Praise God. Looking forward to All Nations Sunday. Invite somebody to come. Amen. We're going to have a Miso Indian group with us on that Sunday. Amen. And their pastor is going to be preaching for us on All Nations Sunday. Amen. And you're going to hear more about them a little later on. And we're excited about what God is doing. Amen. Brother Tabaris and some of his group is going to be with us. Amen. Praise God. We're just going to have a great time worshiping the Lord. Amen. Would you stand and pray with us tonight? Hallelujah. Praise God. Then you can march and come and pray. All of Brother Isaac's group is going to stay in the sanctuary tonight. Amen. So please, young people, and know that there won't be class. Amen. Father, we love you. We give you praise and thanks for your many blessings unto us. Thank you for your power that we feel in this house tonight. Thank you for your blessings upon each and every one of us. We're just excited about you, God, and what you are doing. Let all things be done to your glory. Bless the gift and the giver tonight. I pray in the name of Jesus. And everybody say amen. God bless you as you march and come and give.
Jesus Messiah, name above all names, blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel, the rescue for sinners. Jesus Messiah, oh, name above all names, blessed Redeemer,
Emmanuel,
he's a rescue for sinners,
the rescue for sinners,
the
ransom from heaven,
Jesus Messiah.
Messiah,
yes, you are Lord of all.
Jesus Messiah, Lord.
Amen. Give the Lord some praise tonight. Hallelujah. You are Lord of all. You are my Messiah. You are my King. You are my Lord of all. Praise God. Somebody give him some praise. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Praise him in the sanctuary. Praise him in the power of his might. Let everything that hath breath praise ye the Lord. Amen, amen, amen. Praise God. Praise God. You may be seated tonight. Hallelujah. Before I get into the word of the Lord, I just want to tell you, God is moving in our midst. I want to praise God tonight. 7 being baptized Sunday, 2 being filled with the gift of the Holy Ghost. The Sunday before that, we had another 2 get baptized. Hallelujah. I know my numbers don't add up, but somewhere I had 10 getting baptized and about 4 getting the Holy Ghost in the last 2 weeks. To God be the glory. I want to tell you, God isn't... revival's not coming. Revival is here. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Revival is here if we'll just get plugged into it. Praise God. Revival is here. God is doing many mighty miracles in our midst too. You don't always hear about it, but right before service, and I'm glad to see Brother Rouse here tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Brother Rouse called me, and we all know that he's had difficulties, and I was in the hospital, and I'm not trying to embarrass you, Brother Rouse, but I was there when the doctor pretty much said you've got a year or less to live. Amen. Praise God. His body was filling up with fluid. He was on the verge of having congestive heart failure. We've prayed and prayed and went to the hospital and prayed with him, prayed here at the church. It's a miracle that the man is sitting in this auditorium tonight. And I want to tell you, it's nothing more than by the power of the name of Jesus. Amen. Praise God. Before service, when he called me, he said, amen, Washington Center is one of the few hospitals in this area that will install what they call an LVAC machine into your body to keep your heart pumping. Amen. Again, I'm not trying to embarrass him, but approximately one half of his heart is not pumping. Amen. Pumping any blood through his body. And you know that your heart's going to get overworked and tired, amen, if it continues to function at that rate. Well, Washington Center is one of the few hospitals that has procedures to install an LVAC machine to keep the other side of the heart pumping. The question was whether or not he was even a candidate for that machine because his kidneys were also failing and his body was filling up with fluid and he was going to have to go on dialysis, even to the extent that they put the shunt or the stunt or whatever it is into his body so that they could perform dialysis. The good news tonight after much prayer is that the doctor has determined he doesn't need dialysis. His kidneys are functioning properly. To God be the glory. Hallelujah. To God be the glory. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. That's what God can do. And it was questionable whether or not they were even going to do the LVAC procedure, because usually they do that on candidates that are going to have a heart transplant. Amen. But now they're talking to him about instilling this month that LVAC machine into his body to help his heart start pumping as normal. Amen. Wouldn't it be a wonderful thing if we just continued to pray and that the doctors would determine, hey man, maybe he doesn't even need that LVAC machine anymore. God can perform surgical procedure upon his heart. Hallelujah. To God be the glory. I want you to continue to pray for Brother Rouse. No telling what God is going to do, and use him as a testimony of what God can do. Hallelujah. I don't know if that excites you, but that excites me. That God's not dead. God is still on the throne. God is still performing miracles tonight. Hallelujah. 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 I want somebody to know, no matter what you're going through, God is a healer. God is a way maker. God is a provider tonight. He's your answer. All you got to do is put your faith in him, put your trust in him, put your confidence in him. He'll never leave you. He'll never forsake you. He'll go with you all the way, he said, even to the end of the world. Give the Lord a clap offering of praise. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Amen. God is awesome. Amen. Amen. Have your Bibles tonight. Turn with me to 2 Timothy chapter 2. Amen. 2 Timothy chapter 2. And I want to begin reading. Amen. Let's back up to verse number 8 and read through verse 12. Amen. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 8. Would you mind standing for the reading of the word? Amen. Praise God. Remember that Jesus Christ of the seed of David was raised from the dead according to my gospel, wherein I suffer trouble as an evildoer, even unto bonds. But the word of God is not bound. Therefore, I endure all things for the elect's sake, that they may also obtain the salvation which is in Christ Jesus with eternal glory. It is a faithful saying, for if we be dead with him, we shall also live with him. Anybody want to live with him? Praise God. Verse 12, and if we suffer, we shall also reign with him. And if we deny him, he also will deny us. Let's read verse 13. If we believe not, yet he abideth faithful, and he cannot deny himself. Praise God. I want to point your attention to verse 12, the first part of that. He said, if we suffer, we shall also reign with him. If we suffer, we shall also reign with him. Father, we love you tonight. Grateful for your word tonight. Thankful for all that you're doing in our midst. Hallelujah. Open our hearts, open our minds, open our understanding tonight. Let everything be done to your glory and honor. Anoint my lips of clay tonight. Let my words find a lodging place in a heart. Let faith arise. Let the enemy be scattered, I pray. Let your perfect will be done. In the name of Jesus tonight, I give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. And everybody shout amen. Clap your hands as you're seated unto the Lord tonight. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. We are living in a world tonight, amen, that for lack of a better way of putting it, we all want the blessing, but none of us wants the trials or the tribulations that come along. Amen. There's a doctrine that's called the prosperity doctrine. We all want prosperity, But oftentimes we don't all want what it takes to gain that prosperity. Hallelujah. And I'm reminded of the fact that Jesus, when he came to Bethlehem in a manger as a baby, there was a purpose for his coming. And that purpose was you and I tonight. Praise God. He became flesh, the Bible says, and he dwelt among us. Amen. Praise God. He came for a reason. He came for a purpose. Amen. He came because he had a plan. Amen. How many believe God has a plan tonight? Praise God. How many believe that God has a plan for your life tonight? Hallelujah. God has a plan for every individual that's in this building tonight. He has called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. He has endued you with power from on high. Not that you can just say, praise the Lord, I'm going to heaven. But he called you for his plan. He called you for his purpose. He's got a plan for you. He's got a plan for me tonight. And when I listen to the voice of God and I obey the word of God and I walk not according to my will but according to his will, he leads me and he guides me and he directs me according to his purpose and according to his plan. And therefore, I can say, as the apostle said, all things work together for the good to them that love the Lord. Why? Because we are called according to his purpose. Not my will, God, but thine be done. Where you lead me, I will follow. Yea, here am I, God. Send me, use me. Whatever it is you want me to do, I want to present myself a living sacrifice unto you. Praise God. Praise God. So tonight, amen, I've been teaching on Thursday nights some principles for growth. And tonight I want to talk about the principle of pain. Amen. Hallelujah. Not too awful long ago, I stood before you and I preached a sermon on no pain, no gain. Michael had taken me to the gym, and it's been a little while since I've been to the gym, and Michael had me doing these lunges, these things like this, you know, and man, I'm going to tell you, by the time I got done doing those lunges, that next day I could barely walk. Amen. Hallelujah. And Michael would look at me and he'd say, well, Dad, no pain, no gain. No sympathy out of the young man. Amen. Hallelujah. And don't take it easy on Dad who's getting old. Praise God. No pain, Dad, no gain. Come on, get over it. Don't cry like a baby. Just get up and move. Amen. Do it again. Praise God. Hallelujah. Well, I found out, praise God, that when I went back to the doctor, amen, and he took my A1C for my blood, amen, my blood count was in better shape than it had been in 6 months. I didn't enjoy the pain, but there was some gain in the middle of it all. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. And so it is with God sometimes. Amen. Some of us, we're going through troubles and we're going through trials. We're going through tribulations. We're having hardships. And in the middle of it all, we're wondering, God, where are you at? Have you forgot about me? Have you left me out in the wilderness? Do you know who I am? Have you heard my prayer? I want to tell you, just because God hasn't showed up when you thought he should show up, and just because the prayer hasn't been answered yet, does not mean that God doesn't know who you are and what you're going through and exactly what your situation is. You may think that you're in the middle of pain right now, but there's going to be some gain when God gets done with it all. Can you say amen? Praise God. Brother J.T. Pugh was a great preacher. Amen. And he said many times, he says, amen, do you have a plan to grow? Amen, do you have a plan to grow? I remember reading some of his stuff, and he said, if you don't, then you're not growing. And if you're not growing, he said, you're dying. We're either going to grow or we're going to die. We can't just sit still. We just can't maintain. It can't be business as usual. We either are moving forward or we're moving backward. Well, I don't know about you. I've made up my mind. I want to move forward within the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. I don't want to sit around. I don't want to just take up space. I don't want to just sit here till I die. Hallelujah. Praise God. But I want to grow. I want to grow in the knowledge of the Lord. I want to grow in the power of God. I want to grow in relationship with Him. I want to be a vessel that He can use for this last day revival. I want to be what God wants me to be. Somebody say amen. So again, as I was have been talking to you about the principles, amen, and I'm just going to tell you the last four in case you forgot what the last four were. The first principle that we talked about was the principle of purpose, that God has called us for a purpose, amen. Hallelujah. The second principle was the principle of accepting responsibility. Amen. Somewhere along the line, you got to make up in your mind, as for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord. I'm going to accept the responsibility you've given me, God. I'm going to not only hear the call, but I'm going to react to the call. I accept whatever responsibility you have put before me. The third principle was the principle of spiritual authority. Not only that God has authority in this world and He sets up authorities over us, amen, but we also have authority tonight, praise God, amen. The Bible clearly tells us, obey them that have the rule over you. Why? Because they watch for your soul, amen, hallelujah. And it also tells us that greater is He that's in us than he that's in the world tonight. So when the devil begins to attack you and the devil begins to come against you, you need to be reminded you've got power with God. You have authority with God, that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. Hallelujah. That in the name of Jesus, I can lift up the sword of the Spirit. I can lift up the shield of faith, and the fiery darts of the devil are going to fall off. Why? Because I'm a new creature in Christ Jesus. I've got authority with God tonight. I'm not a nobody. I'm not a has-been. I'm not a worship. I'm not a failure. I'm a child of the King of Kings. I'm a child of the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. The last principle that I shared with you not too long ago was the principle of wisdom. The scripture says wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, when you're getting wisdom, get understanding. If you want understanding in this world in which we live, you need to get your nose into this book right here. Hallelujah. This is wisdom. This is knowledge. This is direction. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. The Bible tells us that heaven and earth shall pass away, but His word shall never pass away. Hallelujah. Thank God for the wisdom of the word. Thank God that I don't need to listen to my coworkers and my friends and those that say it can't be done and those that say it'll never happen that way. Hallelujah. I know a God that's able. Amen. I know a God, Sister Nicole, that's able to touch your father-in-law. I know a God that's able to touch Brother Ralph. I know a God that's able to make a way out of no way. He's already done it. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. So they've come too late to tell me it can't be done. Praise God. So now we come to the principle of pain, not something that we really like to talk about. Amen. I don't think too many of us like pain. Most of us are trying to figure out how do I get rid of the pain. Amen. Praise God. But notice He said in our scripture tonight, if we suffer with Him, we shall also reign with Him. Hallelujah. I'm reminded of that scripture that says, weeping may endure for a night, but joy's coming in the morning. I may be going through some troubles and trials tonight. I may have some hardships in my life tonight. I may cry a few tears tonight. But I want to tell you, brothers and sisters, joy is coming in the morning. When the trumpet sounds, hallelujah, there's going to be great joy in our soul. Goodbye, world. Goodbye. I'm going to a better place. My Father's come to receive me. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. So I may suffer a little bit right now, but what I'm going to gain on the other side is nothing in comparison tonight. Praise God. We're going, hallelujah, to a better place. Eyes not seen and ears not heard. The things that our God has got prepared for us. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. So whatever pain I go through now, hallelujah, count it all joy. Hallelujah. Go through life with a smile on your face. Go through life with a song in your heart. Go through life saying, greater is he that's in me. Yes, I may be going through some trouble, but thank you, Lord, for the trial. Thank you for the tribulation. Thank you that you said you'll not put more upon me than I'm able to bear, but with every temptation, you will make a way of escape. I thank you tonight, God. I thank you tonight, because if it wasn't for the trial, I wouldn't know how to praise you. If it wasn't for the tribulation, I couldn't lift my hands and say, you're a miracle worker. You're our on-time God. You're able. You're able. You're able. You're able to do exceeding and abundantly above all that I think or ask. Praise God. Praise God. So I just want to give you a little heads up that we're basically talking about seven principles. And when you turn to that number seven in scripture, seven is the number of completeness in the word of the Lord. The world was formed in 7 days. Amen. I said the world was formed in 7 days. Amen. Whether you want to believe in evolution or not, I don't really care. The world was formed in 7 days. God said, and it was created. God said, and it happened. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. And so the Bible teaches us in Proverbs 9, it says 9:1, he said, wisdom hath builded her house, and she hath hewn out her seven pillars. Amen. So wisdom in the word of God has seven pillars that it rests upon. Isaiah, amen, seems to define it when he talks about the seven spirits of God, or the divine attributes of God. He begins to list them, amen, and we begin to benefit from them. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. So seven is a significant number in scripture. Again, seven represents God's completeness. Amen. Isaiah 11:2, the Bible says, and the spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. Praise God. Amen. The spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him. I don't know about you, but I want God's spirit to rest upon me. Hallelujah. I want God to give me wisdom and understanding. He said he would be my counselor. He is wonderful counselor, the almighty God. Hallelujah. The everlasting Father. He's the Prince of Peace. When I've got Jesus, I've got a counselor in my life. Hallelujah. When I've got Jesus, I've got the all-powerful one living in my soul tonight. Hallelujah. When I've got Jesus, I've got all the wisdom of this world, hallelujah, because I've got him in my life. Praise God. Praise God. So those were the first four. The last three, if you want to know what the seven are, the principle of pain, the principle of strategy, and the principle of giving up something that's good to get something better. Praise God. And maybe I'll conclude I'm preaching about pain tonight, so I've got two more to give you before I'm done with this series. Amen. Praise God. So we come back. No pain, no gain. Amen. And we know when it comes to athletes and trainers especially since the Olympics have recently just concluded, they could all tell you that there's got to be a time of training. There's got to be a time of pain. There's got to be a time of preparation, if you will. They don't just show up to the game, amen, and expect to win the games, if you will, without any training or without any pain. Amen. So the phrase is also used in a person's life to try to encourage someone. When somebody tells you no pain, no gain, really, supposedly, they're trying to encourage you. Don't quit. Don't give up. Don't get discouraged in well-doing. Hallelujah. Keep trying. Keep pushing. Keep enduring. Hallelujah. Endure the pain. Go through it. Go through it. Grow from it. Hello? Now, we don't enjoy that, do we? We don't enjoy the pain. We want, oh, Jesus, take the pain away. Hallelujah. But Jesus has a plan and Jesus has a purpose. And Jesus knows what the end result is going to be. And the reality is, if there is no pain, there will be no gain. Hallelujah. So if I want to gain from my situation, I'm going to be willing to endure the pain. I know. We want to live in a world without any pain. We want the power, but we don't want the pain. We want the blessing, but we don't want the work that comes along with the blessing. Bless me, Lord. Just poof, here it is. Make it drop out of the sky. Send me that $1 million check in the mail. Yeah. Praise God. And if we're not careful, we buy into this world's philosophy of prosperity doctrine. Amen. But in reality, if you'll look through the scripture, everyone that was successful in God's plan had to endure some pain along the way. Hallelujah. Not too many of us want to praise God for the pain. Why? Because feeling better has become more important to us than finding God. I want to say that again. Feeling better becomes more important to us than finding God. Amen. Because we don't like the pain. Hebrews 12:11. Now no chastening for the present seemeth to be joyous, but grievous. Nevertheless, afterward it yieldeth the peaceable fruit of righteousness unto them which are exercised thereby. No one likes the chastening. Amen. Nobody says, give me more chastisement, God. Give me more pain, God. I haven't had enough. Pour some more on me. No, but he does say, amen, that if we will go through it, that afterward the pain is going to yield some fruit of righteousness. Hallelujah. The fruit is going to be realized after you go through the pain. I'm trying to preach to us about this principle tonight because I know many of you are walking through hardships and many of you are struggling in situations and circumstances in your life. And no doubt, amen, you've even asked yourself, where is God in all my situation? I've come to remind you, amen, that God knows exactly who you are. God knows exactly what you're going through. God God knows every single thing about you and I tonight. And he wants to remind us, amen, hallelujah, that there's going to be a little bit of pain. There's going to be a little bit of suffering. But in the end, it's going to yield some righteous fruit. Hallelujah. In the end, there's going to be joy in the morning. In the end, he's going to wipe away your tears. And you're going to be shouting on the hills of glory. You're going to be praising your God. You're going to be telling other people, he brought me through this trial. He brought me through that tribulation. He brought me through this situation. And my God is not a liar. He said he'd never make me, he'd never leave me. He'll never forsake me. He'll make a way when there seems to be no way. And if he'll take me through that trial, he's going to take me through this trial. If he'll bring me through that temptation, he's going to take me through the next temptation. And somehow my faith begins to build. My confidence begins to build. And I say, hey, God before me, who can be against me? I am more than a conqueror through Christ Jesus my Lord. Devil, you're a liar and you're the father of lies. Hallelujah. Greater is he that's in me than he that's in this world. And faith begins to rise. And you feel like David when he picked up those rocks and he was facing a Goliath. And he says, you come against me with sword and spear, but I'm coming against you in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, God is for you. God is with you. God is your healer. God is your way maker. God is your provider. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Don't get distracted about the pain. Realize the pain is just a necessary ingredient to get you into the fruit of righteousness that God wants to do in your life. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise him for the pain. Praise him for the trial. Praise him for the tribulation. All things work together. All things work together. All things work together for the good. Hallelujah. 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 That word chastening in the Greek literally means training. Praise God. So when God begins to chasten you, you are in God's training camp. God is training you. Amen. Hallelujah. He's training you because he's got a plan for your life. He's got a purpose for your life. Hallelujah. And he realizes that the more chastisement that comes your way, the better trained you're going to be at handling the problem and the situation. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. And he realizes the more that we are trained, that down the road, the bigger the spiritual victory is going to be. Praise God. I said there's a spiritual victory down the road. Amen. We don't enjoy the training. We don't enjoy the pain. We don't enjoy the persecution. But the bigger the pain, hallelujah, the greater the victory. C.S. Lewis, he wrote and he said, God whispers to us in our pleasures, speaks in our conscience, but shouts to us in pain. Amen. He shouts to us when we're in pain. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. We've got to take part in the suffering of God. Think about Jesus when he's on his way to the cross. Do you really think he enjoyed the pain? Did he enjoy it when they whipped him with a cat of nine tails? Did he enjoy it when they spat upon him, mocked him, and made fun of him? Did he enjoy it when they put that crown of thorns upon his head and the blood came rushing down? But he knew that he must endure the pain. Because there was a greater purpose. There was a greater plan that he had to go to Golgotha. He didn't enjoy the nails being nailed in his hands and feet or the sword thrust into his side. But he endured it all because he loved you and I. Greater love hath no man than this, than a man would lay down his life for a friend. Thank God it was love that made him endure the pain. Woo, hallelujah. It was love that endured all things that we might have life and have it abundantly. Hallelujah. God loved you and I enough to endure the pain. Woo, I'm preaching to somebody tonight. You're going through the pain and God loves you enough, hallelujah, that he endured it for you. And we have to ask ourselves, are we willing to endure the pain and the shame and the heartache and the suffering that others seem to cause us? Amen. Will we do it with love? Amen. Philippians chapter 3, verse 10. Paul says that I may know him and the power of his resurrection. And the fellowship of his sufferings made conformable unto his death. Paul says, I want to know him. Now we all want to know him in the power of his might. But not too many of us preach about the fellowship of his sufferings. We don't like to talk about how he suffered. Give me the power, God. Give me the deliverance, God. Take away the pain, God. But if there would have been no victory if there had been no pain. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Paul said, I want to know him in the power of his resurrection. And also in the fellowship of his suffering. The only way we can really know Christ is if we become made in his image or made like unto him. Isaiah 53 tells us, talking about Jesus, that he was despised and he was rejected of men. A man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. He experienced the pain and the rejections of life. He was wounded, it says, for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. Yet his pain propelled him towards his destiny. Amen. Hallelujah. In life, we've got to suffer some pain. But if you and I will go through the process, God will make us the product that he wants us to be in the kingdom for his purpose. Amen. I want to be what God wants me to be. Oh, Lord, mold me, make me, shape me into what it is you want me to become. Hallelujah. 1 Peter 4 and 12, he said, Beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you. Amen. Hallelujah. As though some strange thing has happened unto you. But rejoice, rejoice, rejoice when the pain comes into your life. Rejoice when the trials come into your life. Hallelujah. Rejoice in as much as ye are partakers of Christ's sufferings. But when his glory shall be revealed, ye may be glad also with exceeding joy. Hallelujah. We're going to be glad one day with exceeding joy. Hallelujah. Every trial that we've gone through, every tribulation, every time of persecution, it's going to be worth it. It's going to be worth it just to hear him say, Well done, thou good and thou faithful servant. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for helping me endure the pain. Thank you for every trial I traveled. Thank you for every mountaintop I had to climb. Thank you for every time they persecuted me, God. Hallelujah. You made me stronger. You made me better. You got the dross out of my life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So one of the greatest motivators to bring about change in our life is pain. And God, at times, He allows us to go through the pain in order to get to the provision that He's not only has for us, but for those we can influence in our lives as well. You see, God gets the glory after He brings you through victorious. Hallelujah. Brother Rouse is here, and I talked about him in the beginning. I'm going to tell you, he didn't enjoy 1 minute what he was going through. I don't believe he did. But tonight he's here, and tonight we're giving God praise. And God is getting the honor, and God is getting the praise tonight. Why? Because God is awesome. Because God can do what nobody else can do. Hallelujah. When the doctor can't do anything else, King Jesus can walk into a hospital room. Hallelujah. And one word from the master can change everything. Hallelujah. So we may be weeping tonight, but joy is coming in the morning when the miracle comes, when the power comes, when the deliverer comes, when the healer comes, when the waymaker comes. There's great joy. Hallelujah. Amen. And that's when we need to be men and women of God and go and tell everybody that we come in contact. You know what my God did? My God healed Brother Ralph. My God made a way for him. My God touched him. Praise God. And as we begin to live, lift him up. Amen. Lift up the name of Jesus. God gets the glory and God gets the praise and God gets the honor. And that's what God wants. Amen. You can talk about the problem if you want to, but I want to talk about the miracle working God I serve. Hallelujah. You can complain about your situation if you want to, but I'd like to tell somebody, God brought me through. God made a way. God is a present help in the time of trouble. Praise God. Praise God. And sometimes God allows us to go through things just so we can benefit other people. Hallelujah, because God sees the bigger picture. Amen. Praise God. And I'm going to close with this tonight. Praise God. Think about Joseph. Favored of his father, hated of his brothers. Hated so much by his brothers that his brothers threw him in the pit, sold him into slavery, plotted to kill him. Amen. Praise God. He was hated. He was taken, as you know, into Egypt, and he was sold again. And every time he turned around, he probably felt like what was promised to him. I don't know if he doubted or not, but I know I would start to doubt. Where's my promise, God? Where you at, God? I didn't think it was going to be like this. Hallelujah. See, Joseph had to endure some pain. A lot of pain. But even though as he was enduring the pain, God was still with him. Woo, hallelujah. I'm trying to tell somebody tonight, God's with you in your pain. God knows where you're at. God knows what you're going through, and God's with you in your pain. Hallelujah. So Joseph was in pain, and hallelujah, but God was still with him. God had not forgotten him. God had not abandoned him. And finally, You know the end of the story, how Joseph rises to be the second only to the king of all the land. And the whole time, God was preparing him for that position. He was in God's training camp. Praise God. Amen. He didn't enjoy the pain, but he endured it. He went through it. And God brought him out at the other end and put him second in command in all the kingdom. Hallelujah. What am I trying to say? I'm saying God's got a plan for your life. God's got a purpose for your life. And you may be going through some pain right now, but don't give up on God. Don't throw the towel in and quit. Don't sit around and complain about your situation and circumstances. Just let faith arise and say, God's going to bring me through. I don't know when it's going to happen. I don't know how it's going to happen. But God has promised me that he would never fail me. He would never let me down. He's going to bring me through. Hallelujah. Get a song in the middle of your trial. Amen. Let faith arise. I don't know about you, but when I'm going through depressing times, I like to get me an old hymn or something. I just start singing. Hallelujah. Amen. And if that don't work, you need to come to an altar and start praying. You start praying and you start singing and you start praising God. And I guarantee you one thing, God will start showing up. God will start making a way out of no way, because God responds to faith. Hallelujah. I said, God responds to faith. Faith calls those things that are not as though they are, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. And so what you need to do is you need to let your faith arise, and you need to begin to praise God. You need to begin to thank God. You need to begin to sing a song. Hallelujah. Amen. And say, oh, goodbye, world, goodbye. Amen. I start singing about the blood. The blood will never lose its power. Hallelujah. Thank God for the blood. Amen. My great and mighty is the Lord my God. Hallelujah. And I begin to encourage myself. I begin to sing praises to God. I begin to say, God, I don't know what I'm going through, why I'm going through it, but I know one thing. You're with me every step of the way. Hallelujah. Amen. If you can part the Red Sea for the children of Israel, you can part the Red Sea for me. Hallelujah. If you can shut the mouth of lions for Daniel, you can shut the mouth of my adversary. Hallelujah. If you can be with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in a fiery furnace, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. And when I begin to praise him and I begin to remind him, amen, I'm a child of his. Hallelujah. Faith begins to rise. A boldness in the spirit begins to rise. Hallelujah. And I feel that shield of faith begin to rise. I take out that sword and I say, in the name of Jesus, devil, get thee behind me. Hallelujah. And I proclaim the victory. Why? Because we are more than conquerors. We are more than conquerors. Hallelujah. We are the mighty marching family of the kingdom of God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. God's not going to fail you. God's not going to forget about you. Hallelujah. So don't misinterpret your pain and your struggle or your circumstances as God's punishment. God's not punishing you because he's upset with you. He's trying to position you so that you and I will fulfill our purpose. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And remember what Romans 8:58 says, that all things work together for the good to them that love God, to them that are called according to his purpose. Hallelujah. We are called according to the purpose of God. Amen. Let's stand and give him some praise tonight. Praise God. Stand and lift your hands. Give God some praise. Thank you, Lord, for your call upon me. Thank you for your blessing upon me. Thank you for your hand upon me. Thank you for your anointing upon us tonight, God. Hallelujah. Thank you for every trial you've brought me through. Thank you for every tribulation and every situation and every circumstance. I give you praise tonight, God. Hallelujah. You are wonderful. You are mighty. You are great. You are greatly to be praised. I wonder tonight if you would just step out and come down to this altar. Let's close this service out tonight by giving God some praise and thanking him for his blessing and thanking him for his goodness. Come on. Before we go home, come on down and lift your hands and say, God, I want to thank you for your blessings in my life. I want to thank you for every trial I've gone through. I want to thank you that you've been faithful to me all along the way. I praise you. I bless you. I thank you tonight, God. Have your will in my life. Have your way in my soul. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Come on, I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. I praise you tonight, God. I thank you tonight for your blessings, Lord. You've not left me. You've not forsaken me. You're a right now God. Hallelujah. Bless my sisters tonight, God. Bless my brothers tonight. Let the glory of the Lord be upon them. Let your blessing be upon them. Let your will be accomplished in them and through them. Hallelujah. Come on, pray one for another tonight. Let the Lord touch you. Let faith arise. Let the enemy be scattered tonight. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Let there be a word of encouragement. Let there be a word of faith tonight, God. Let there be a word, I pray. Bless them. Praise them. Halabohu shamakayandoi. In the name of Jesus, we give you glory, we give you honor, we give you praise. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
My God, how great you are, how great you are. My God. My God, how great you are. My God, how great you are.